it's an honor to come back. It's such a beautiful island, and to be asked to come here to celebrate with the island about it, and also be very active about the fact that tourism is thriving. It's ready. People should be coming here all the time. I'm going to tell everybody. Yes, of course I took dessert. So on brunch on Sunday, I'm going to be making the dessert, making 500 and about 550 cinnamon rolls with bacon, and then I'm taking the local rum and I'm putting that into a caramel sauce. So I'm serving my little cinnamon rolls with bacon, a little whipped cream cheese on top, and then a caramel sauce made of rum. What I expect, everything that I've seen already, it's a beautiful island, beautiful people, amazing food after 2 days. And I expect, thank goodness it's not a competition, because I'd win with my cinnamon rolls. I'm just going to say that now. To the camera, I would win. But otherwise, you know, leave it to me with 90 degree weather to make something that has to be temperamental. But it's going to be phenomenal. We're just super excited.
I think it was important to have the event. Puerto Rico is ready to welcome visitors. We went through some very difficult and challenging months, and we still have some work ahead of us, but the reality is that people can come here, they can come and visit, they can enjoy Puerto Rico to the fullest, the attractions, the hotels, everything is ready to receive them. We have a few hotels that are still under renovation, but they will be opening between now and the end of the year. So every month we have new inventory available. The venue is spectacular. I mean, as you can see, this location is bigger. It's really, really easy. The parking is right there. The municipality has done an incredible job after everything that it went through with the visit of our friend Irma and Maria. So I think it's going to be a total success. We're hoping to have close to 6,000 people coming for the weekend. Probably we'll have a combination, because to our surprise, about 3 months ago, we started getting calls from people from the States and the Caribbean asking about the event. So we're very happy and very hopeful that things will be great.
In the States, I cook with Puerto Rican flavor profiles. I have a cuisine that I've labeled Cali Weekend Cuisine. I'm very excited to share what I've developed in California, in Puerto Rico, and I'm so excited that we're back up in business. I want everyone to know that Puerto Rico is more than a debt, more than a hurricane, that we are some of the strongest people in the whole world, and you can knock us down with two hurricanes back to back. We're back up, baby, and we're ready for business. I mean, this is, you don't find beauty like this many places in the world. This is one of the most incredible, it's paradise. And I'm so excited to have the opportunity to cook here with people that I really believe are like Puerto Rican culinary royalty. It's an incredible honor. I'm going to be making a play on a spam musubi, which is a Hawaiian dish, but I'm doing it with a sweet fried plantain. And instead of the seaweed wrap, the nori wrap, we're going to have a quail egg on top. So the quail egg is going to be the sauce, the sweetness of the plantain, and it's sort of it's a play on a very common Puerto Rican breakfast, you know, plátanos with arroz, and it's just going to be so yummy.
We've heard about this event for over 10 years, so we're super excited to be here. It's one of the biggest culinary experiences, extravaganzas, in the world. So when they invited me, I just had to be here and bring some of my Miami flavor here. My expectations are super high. There's so many amazing chefs. Puerto Rican food, we have some from Canada, we have some from all over the place, so I am ready to try all of it, and of course with a special touch in Puerto Rico, so it can't get any better than that. For Sunday, I'm going to be making a French toast. We've all had a French toast, so I'm going to make my French toast a little extra special by making a banana foster French toast. So we have two of our favorite desserts in one. We have those bananas, and I'm going to cook them in a few rum, so you're going to light it up and all of those flames. Cook that sugar with the cinnamon, with the butter, and it's going to make this nice, beautiful glaze. We're going to throw on top of our French toast, and then we're going to top it up with some leche condensada, some extra love. Last one I participated in is the South Beach Food and Wine Festival, and let me tell you what, you guys are doing such an amazing job, because this is, I think, is as even as the South Beach Food and Wine Festival. And you guys got it right. You have the food, you have the great chefs, you have the entertainment, that you have it all. Best moment right now, and we are Puerto Rico, and we, because I'm Latin. We're ready to start bringing people over. The food is great, the entertainment is great, the drinks are great, the people are great. The beach can't be any more perfect.
Yeah, the Saborea is more important than ever. We're showing the world that Puerto Rico is open for tourism. So this is a great event to do so. We have chefs that are renowned chefs and coming from all over the world. We also have press that is coming from all over the world, because this is a great opportunity to show the world that we are open for tourism. We formally announced that this past December and have been building up to this moment. So this is an exciting time. How can you beat this backdrop? How can you beat this great event? So we're excited about this event, and we're sure the participation is going to be ample. We're in this beautiful site that is going to be open this weekend as well. So I think the expectation of attendance is going to be significantly more than in years past, just because we're located here, that everyone's coming to the beach. So it's just a stone's throw away from actually coming and enjoying Saborea, beyond everyone that's actually coming and paying their ticket to be here ahead of time. I'm sure there's also going to be a lot of passerbys that are going to stop by and enjoy everything that Saborea has to offer this weekend.